Couple of other things that you should know, my friends. If you are in need of the Wi-Fi, the password is feel welcome. So that's it. I saw like 80% of you grab your phone then and get onto the Wi-Fi. So that's great to see. It's feel welcome. So that's the one with the Novotel there. Morning and afternoon tea is going to be served in this room. And the theme this year is remote possibilities, going the distance for country. So talking about things local and territory governments, nonprofits and industry can be doing and are doing for key waste management issues and solutions. Now, one of the big parts of your wonderful symposium today is networking and making some connections. Our next presenter hasn't quite walked into the room yet. So what we're going to do, oh, he is. Oh, fantastic. Look at that. Perfectly timed. Forget that. Friends, we are going to kick things off with the welcome address for your symposium. So that rock star round of applause has got to make a lot of noise to get our next presenter all the way to the front. Local Government Association of the Northern Territory President and Lord Mayor of the City of Darwin, please welcome Convert Scarless.
Thank you, Amy. We meet again. We used to be meeting regularly when I was in Leukemia Foundation. Good morning, everyone. It is a great pleasure to see you here today. Some of my elected colleagues, Robin, welcome. And Donna, we're meeting on Arakia country, quite right so too. And quite right so, the weather's a bit strange, isn't it? But I'll tell you what, it's better than Melbourne. 11 degrees and raining, bring it on. It is a great pleasure to welcome everyone today in Legan's Waste Management Symposium and see so many people from across a diverse range of government, non-government and industry sectors. Apologize for my voice. Last weekend, who had the Creek Glendy, and I had a really good time. In the local government sector, waste management is at the forefront of service delivery. But as everyone here today is aware of, the territory sees unique complexities in the delivery of these services in a regional or remote context. I don't know if you know my background. I used to be an environmental health officer. I worked in the city of Wanneroo, town of Port Hedland, and here in Darwin for the health department. So I've got a very close relationship with rubbish tips or waste management. Let me describe you the waste management facility I found in Port Hedland. I had my interview in May 1990. They gave me a card and they told me to go have a look at it. I went to have a look at it. And it was a D6. And Lucifer was sitting on top of it, smiling, and everything around him was burning. And I got a job and I went in July 1990. And I thought, like, I better go and have a look at this rubbish tip. There was a D6 and the guy was sitting on top of it and everything around it was burning. Plastic, car tires, everything, you name it. Took us about a year to fix it, but we did fix it. How complex the situation is? 1993, I came here, got a phone call from the then president of Litchfield Shire, Mr. Jerry Wood. He wanted to discuss about rubbish disposal site. 1993, we start talking about it. There isn't any new rubbish disposal site in Darwin yet. And it's not going to be another one for 10 to 20 years, I reckon. So it becomes more and more difficult to establish a new rubbish disposal site. And in our site, in Darwin, you keep renting new areas, leasing new areas, so we can actually operate for a long, long time. So this is why this symposium is very, very important, especially for people outside the Darwin metropolitan area. For many territorians, waste management is something you might only think about on bin day, but it is without doubt one of the most crucial services required on a daily basis across the territory. As the Lord Mayor of the territory's largest local government municipality, I see the City of Darwin continue to lead these conversations and find solutions for increased resource recovery across the top end. This includes facilitating opportunities for new local industries across the territory. This is really not an easy task given our small and dispersed population base, but can be achieved with everyone working together. The complexity of managing waste in today's society is often undervalued or not fully understood. Lack of access to waste management facilities can be detrimental both to the environment and the associated impact on human health if not managed appropriately. City of Darwin has been leading the way in the provision of waste and resource recovery facilities and outcomes for the greater Darwin area. This has been achieved working with local contractors and industry. To provide a few examples, construction of a new state-of-the-art landfill cell at the Salt Bay Waste Management Facility has been completed at a cost of $8.5 million. This new facility probably will last about 7 years, but if we're smart enough, we do a lot of recycling, we can extend it. And we'll be working very close with Veolia, who manage our rubbish tip, to make sure this is happening. We're already recycling metal, about 200 tons a month. We'd like to recycle as many bottles as possible. And of course, the big problem, what are we doing with the bloody solar panels? Even though the new landfill cell is needed to deal with domestic and commercial waste generated by the Down community, everyone needs to rethink how waste can be diverted. The diversion of waste will in turn help reduce our effect on climate change and the environment. Currently, we implement a number of diversionary programs. These include a partnership with helping people achieve to operate the recycling facility and resale shop. You'd be amazed how many people who are having Darwin, they go to that shop to furnish their apartments. The processing of domestic and commercial green waste for malt sale and malt sale. Everybody in Darwin's got a garden, goes to the tip to get malts because it keeps the garden healthy, cut the water consumption, and you don't have soil blowing everywhere. It works really well. But now we have been working with Veolia and a company from Adelaide to convert a lot of this green waste to compost, to return carbon to the environment and to the soil. Concrete crushing on-site reuse. We've got one on-site. Recently, I was approached by another company. They've got a concrete crushing facility. They want to actually work with us to provide concrete, reusable concrete, as a base for our roads. Great idea. The landfill gas management facility generates renewable energy by utilizing methane from the decomposition of the waste. And we've got a power station that generates power for 1,000 houses. We installed 260 solar panels on the Salt Bay Waste Management Facility. Great initiative will assist council to meet our commitment for zero emissions from council operations by 2030. It also reduced operating costs significantly, help us achieve the Northern Territory Government's 50% renewable energy target. What can we do to do more? How can we actually have bigger and better changes? Achieving a circular economy is at the forefront of advancing resource recovery in the future. And the City of Down is facilitating this, transitioning in a number of key areas, like the development of a state-of-the-art leachate treatment facility. One of our biggest problems is that rubbish tips are not new. They've been there for a long, long time, generating leachates. If it's not lined properly to contain the leachates, they can find their way to the underground water, contaminating the environment. City of Darwin, we've got cells that they're not state of the art because they were done about 30, 35 years ago, and the new ones are state of the art. So we're collecting the leachates, and we've got now a facility that can treat these leachates to a level that can be released to the environment without causing any harm. Expensive? Yes. Good? Fantastic. For the environment? Great news. We do not cause any damage in the environment, especially where our tip is, because very, very close to the tidal area, and anything that would go to the groundwater, it will find its way up to the surface, and there will be a lot of complaints by the public and EPA, not forget EPA. We continue to explore new waste diversion initiatives and currently finalizing a waste resource recovery strategy to deliver best practice initiatives and highlight our direction over the next 10 years. This strategy will encompass key strategic needs, including supporting and partnering with our community, local business, and industry to collaborate on activities and services aimed at increasing the circular economy in the region. Increased landfill diversion, contamination reduction, and education will form a big part of this process. Ladies and gentlemen, everybody wants councils to do everything. In our case, everybody wants us to recycle every single bottle, to recycle every single carbon carton, and recycle every little bit of concrete that comes out of old buildings. Well, at this stage, we can't. First of all, because we don't have all the facilities. Second, because there's no demand. We're so small. We can crush as much concrete as you like, but there are so many roads we can actually construct. And sometimes the supply of recycled concrete, it's much, much bigger than the need we've got to do roads. But we should not do it. We can do it and stockpile it for later. bottles. Recently, we had a big debate about why the bottles go to the rubbish tip. Well, if everybody takes his beer bottles to the recycling depot, can take 10 cents for each bottle. It's the problem with the green bottles. You know, you drink too much wine in the territory, and nobody recycles the wine. So it has to be gone to the landfill. But again, as I said to you before, now we've got people that come out of the blue and says, we can crush it to the size of sand so it can be used as building material. Now you're telling me, come over, talk to us more about it. We'd like to know more about you. So we really try. The reality is we're a small jurisdiction and big jurisdiction, 1.5 million square kilometers with so many communities spread out, and every community has to have its waste disposal facility. But it would be ideal if we had all these communities in 100 kilometers radius. We can have a lot of recycling taking place because it makes economic sense. But think bringing bottles from Yundumu or Nalamboy. We can't even manage to get the car bodies because of such a distance. You can imagine what happened with bottles. But we're not giving up. We're trying. We want to increase recycling for the benefit of the environment. But at the end of the day, if we can extend the lifespan of our tip or rubbish tip, saves money for council. That means your rates will not go up.
Thank you very much, Convatskalis. And I like that the last note you left on is rates not going up, like leave everyone up here. That's great. Thank you. And everybody, welcome. The symposium is officially kicked off now. So let's put our hands together and celebrate, because the hard work that you're all doing is being reflected today. So go on, a round of applause for yourselves. The symposium started. Great.